Wanted to. Do you want to talk about the Curse of Strahd campaign?
Yeah, we can just talk about D&D in general, but I'll bring up the Curse of Strahd campaign.
Okay. I'll let you start and lead this.
Sure. So we're playing D&D. Surprise.
We're finally getting back to it.
Yeah, now that I have some time, now that I've
Well, now we
graduated.
all have time.
Yeah. I should have said all, but whatever. And it's been going good, I think.
I've had a lot of fun the past 2 nights.
Yeah, so I basically prepared one big dungeon for you guys, and we finished it in about 2 nights, where you guys got there, scouted it out, found the boss, and some minor story stuff. You guys had the big fight with her. It was a witch in a flying, like a flying skull. Sorry, I just ate Cane's before this. I'm a little bit burpy. The witch is in like this floating skull mount that like flies around this big
Yeah.
marsh, and her hut that she lives in grows these giant root legs and starts attacking you guys. And for reference, the people playing, it's my buddy Elliot right here across from me, obviously. You play a rogue. And when we were doing the combat, you had some of your stats mixed up a bit. So your attack rolls were way suboptimal. Like you were getting about +3 attack when you should have been getting like +7, which is what it at right now. Which
Yeah.
doesn't seem like a lot, but it makes a big deal
Well, that
whenever
makes a big difference.
you're rolling for a 20-sided die. Like a +7 is like such a big gap, that you can cross, to hit an enemy. So yeah, the big highlights of that fight were when Blake's character, the half-orc barbarian, he full sprinted across the marsh and then jumped 20
That
feet
was so
up into
sick.
the air.
Going down in the function. Where it's at.